We are looking into continuous beam. In the last classes, we were analyzing the continuous beam by using slope deflection method. So actually, where the slope deflection is used and what are the places you have the continuous beam. Here you can see a picture which is a concrete structure. This is a reinforced concrete structure. Beam and column structure. So it is a framed structure. This is what it is intended. So whatever the structure which is built by using beam and column, definitely you will have a continuous beam here. You can observe that in all the levels of the frame, in the first floor, second and the third floor, you can see a column and beam structure which is being connected here. And what you can observe here is all are fixed beam.
The connectivity between these two beams is fixed. Whatever the practical cases which you are seeing in real life, we'll be having this continuous beam. This is a fixed and continuous. All the joints are fixed and they are continuous. So in your problem, you might have a hinge end, a roller end like that, you might have a different hinge condition. So you have to observe that and you have to, whatever you are solving currently and for the problem, you have to link with what you are going to do. You are going to unset the structure. You should understand that what are the supports are there, how do the catch. So like that, if you see there is a long column and this is a short column. So in sense of materials, you would have studied what is long column and short column. So there is different types of columns in the construction itself. Not even a single thing will be unique. You can see the column height nearly will be 10 feet. That is 3.2 meters. And you can see a twice of that. It will be 6.4 meters and around 0.3 meters it will be there. And this will be a long column effect. And this will be a short column with the continuity. So how much span is here? Span 1 and span 2. The first floor has 2 spans, but the third floor has 1, 2, 3 and 4. They have 4 spans. So if you are dealing a concrete structure, you might have to do number of continuous beam design or analysis. So you cannot do only one beam analysis and complete the process. So it will be taking 2 or 3 beam according to the architectural view. See, architect is a important thing where you get more aesthetics. You can see our college building here. It is being filled by the panels. So these are all glass panels. If you see the elevation of our college campus, so you will be having the glass panels. So it will be in the color of red and yellow along with the ash color. So you will be having that much of facade work. So these works are only for architectural purpose, for better appearance. So it does not help the structure in strength wise or durability wise. They are only, see, many of the structure which are built in a structure not for taking the load. But primarily what you are doing here is, whatever might be the architect will be giving the plan. So he might give the design, you the engineers have to make the structure into real world. The architects and civil engineers are the 2 persons which are there for making a monument or a structure. Without architect help or civil engineers help, no structure in this world can be built. So wonders are being made. So you can see tunnel like structures are available below the water. So around 30 kilometers they are constructing below the water. So these are all possible only with the 2 persons. So the you can see that number of bridges will not be same in a developed countries and cities. Each and everyone will be unique. See, I have visited IIT Kanpur before, way before a decade. I saw that many of the staircases are not same. You can see the staircase here. This is a dogleg staircase and open well staircase which are there in our college. So if you have known the different types of staircase, so there is a
straight staircase. There are 5 or 6 different types of staircase are there. There is a spiral type staircase. So when the space is very less, say for example you have 5 feet by 5 feet length, only that much of area is available, but you have to make a staircase in the sense you have to go for a spiral staircase. So whenever you see a circular water tank, so in a water tank they will be providing the spiral staircase. So whenever you have a wide space, when you need more opening and when you need more air circulation, they will go for open well staircase. So whatever you see in our staircase at the center of our building, it is a open well. See, you can, if you are climbing there, you can see a well in between the 3 flight. So there will be 3 flight in your staircase, and center there will be a well there. Why they are providing? It is for air circulation. Can you provide in your building? Yes. Can you provide for residential house? Not necessary. Why? Because maximum you will be having 10% in a house. Maximum I am saying. Minimum you will be having 2%. So for that amount of people, that much of staircase is not required. That much of space is not required. The architect will not plan according to his own preference. So he will imagine that how many people will be there. If he is building a theater and if he is giving a plan, that plan and dimension will be handling of these things and all. So there is a cubic volume of air circulation required per minimum person. It is there in National Building Code. So if you refer that, it is a wonderful book, but it is very tedious to go through. You are looking into your own textbook, and it will be around 240 or 300 pages. So you will study for 6 long months for a subject. But National Building Code is the unique book in our country which has all the things which has to be learnt by a civil engineer. But it is not in our curriculum. It will be there whenever there is disputes. So there will be disputes in a state, there will be disputes between the client. So whenever there is a dispute, they will look into the National Building Code. So as a civil engineer, you at least read once. It is freely available in website. You can download the National Building Code and at least you refer. They have given the standard and guideline. You cannot build a structure by your own. See, my house can be 10 feet by 5 feet. So this is my hall. Everyone are saying hall should be 10 feet by 10 feet at least, or 20 feet by 20 feet. It should be like that. Who is going to stop? This is my house. This is my land. I am going to make 10 feet by 5 feet. So this is my hall. Who is going to raise question? You can ask that. But as a civil engineer, if you refer the National Building Code, there is a norm that if a person is living, he need minimum air circulation in order to live a healthy life. So they had a formula and they have derived that per this much of cubic volume. Definitely there will be a height of 10 feet in each and every house minimum. So 10 feet height, length is 10 feet. Let us take the width also 5 feet. So it will be around how much? 100 into 5 will be 500. So 500 cubic feet of volume is available. So for this much availability, what is the minimum air circulation is required? In a house it is not required that much, but in a cinema theater, imagine that no ventilation will be there. You are being locked inside a room, isn't it? There will be no air circulation, only the air conditioner will be available. So the people has to design that for this much capacity. If the theater is 450 members capacity, for that 450 members, how much of air intake is required? So for that one, you have to design the AC. So there is air circulation inside which has to be provided. Civil engineering is not only making certain things, but for giving certain plan or appearance or a structure, it needs a number of things to decide certain things. You cannot decide just like that. So this is what I intended to say here. So you have to make the air condition for that capacity, and it should not be minimum to the National Building Code guideline. And what I say here is, the architect and the civil engineers are essential to build a good structure. Whatever the architect is giving as aesthetic, It will be only in paper. It will not come to a real life unless a civil engineer is working on it. So you are the person who is making the things real. The paperwork into reality. This is the difference. So whatever they can plan, whatever you can see in your laptop or a paper, it has to be real. So there is a structure which is built here. It is a in the highway there is a statue which is being built here, and you see and you observe nearly our college height. It will be around more than 30 meter height. There is a structure which is being built. It is given by an architect. Your problems will be different for each and every case. First, you have to be comfortable with the conventional case. Then you can build a structure. Have you seen Sardar Vallabhai Patel structure? It is a very long structure. It is built by a civil engineer. So you will be studying fixed beam, continuous beam, fixed end, hinged end, roller, like that you will study. But someone will give you an opportunity to build a structure like a monument. So there will be a thing which is irregular. So you cannot see a continuous beam or like this. You have to practice. So whatever you are currently doing today, you have to practice. So if you practice for conventional thing, you can do many non-conventional structure. And here you can see an example of simply supported beam. Why we say simply supported in the sense, you will be having two type of column and the beam is erected and just it is supported. This is a prefabricated structure. Have you heard about that? Already the beam will be made, already the column will be made, just they will install. So for a case of simply supported end, if a problem is being solved by you, a simply supported beam carries a UDL. This is the case. So you have to imagine this, you are making a prefabricated structure and you are designing. So for each and every case in your analytical work has some practical applicability. And another case, this is a prefabricated structure in a grid. So you can see the grid lines here, and along with the grid line you will be having the continuous beam. So these are all the cases of simply supported end. So with this understanding you have to deal a structure. See, currently when you are looking into a structure, it will not look like this. What you are doing practically, you are assuming certain things. The both the ends are fixed and in between ends are being hinged. So you can see the example here. The same structure is being designed now by you, but this is practical and the analytical thing is this one. So there is a uniformly distributed load and rarely you will be having a point load. Here in this problem, you have a point load of 5 kN and 8 kN, isn't it? So in practical case, for residential house, there is minimum requirement for point load. There will be no point load. If you are making a manufacturing unit or warehouse, see, you have a library above it, isn't it? For each and every library, if you are in future, you will be a civil engineer, keep in mind that whenever you are building a library structure, you have to at least imagine the distance between the two library racks. So you will be having each and every library racks, and if a rack is there, definitely there will be 1000 to 2000 kg per rack. So can you lift that rack by yourself? Book is a most heaviest thing. So you know by yourself, if you are carrying 10 number of books, it will be heavy. 1 kg is how many kilonewton? Or 100 kg is how many kilonewton? Okay, 1 kg is how many newton? 1 kg equals 9.81 newton, that is 10 newton. Okay, what is 1000 kg? If 1 kg is 10 newton, what is 1000 kg? 10,000 newton, that is 10 kilonewton. So if a library structure is being built, definitely a library rack will be having 1000 kg. And whenever you are having a rack, what you should remember? You should, when you are designing, you should make the rack as a point load, and then you have to do. You will be having number of racks, isn't it? Throughout the span, you will be having number of racks. So there is a minimum clearance distance. At least they will have 0.5 meter distance. So for each and every 0.5 meter distance, you should provide a point load, then you have to analyze. If not, your structure is going to have irregular deformation, there will be cracks, it will be found after the placement of the load. So whatever might be the result, there is a cause for that. If you find any crack, if you find any irregular deformation, there will be a cause. So this is why what structure you are building is very much essential. If it is for residential purpose or it is for a library, if it is for a workshop, definitely a workshop will be having more number of machines. So machines, at least they will have 1000 to 2500. Say for example another industry, automobile industry, if they are carrying any car work, if they are keeping the car in their parking, a car at least have 1500 kg, isn't it? Dead weight in the sense, without any humans, without any weight, it will be having 1500 kg. If it is 1500 kg, what is the kilonewton? 15 kilonewton, isn't it? So you have to assume the 15 kilonewton. If you are designing which structure, parking structure, the residential building is different, and if you are building a parking structure is different. You should assume what are the loads which are coming, and then you have to make into a point load to proceed your structure. Okay, now you can take out this problem. A continuous beam ABC consists of 3 spans and is loaded as shown in figure. This is a 3 span continuous beam, and end A and D are fixed. Determine the bending moment at supports and plot the bending moment diagram. So this is the requirement. You have to solve this by slope deflection method. The two bending moments are asked here. What is it? Positive and negative bending moment. How did they say? Determine the bending moment at support. The support only have negative bending moment. This is what I explained in the earlier class. If you are supporting a beam, if you are making any point load, at the ends you will be having negative bending moment. So that is why at the support you will be having negative moment, which is being identified by slope deflection method. And you have to find the span bending moment, that is positive bending moment. Okay, first let us solve this by using slope deflection method. And also note here that the I is different. What is I here? You can see the span A and B is having 2 kilonewton per meter as the UDL, and B to C is 5 kilonewton. Can you see the 2I? There is a letter they have mentioned it as 2I. This is the odd one. You have to take it into account. What do you mean by that? The moment of inertia. What is I? I is known as moment of inertia. So between span B and C, the moment of inertia is higher, that is twice. It might be the beam which is having different depth. Okay, between C and D is I. You have to note it down while you are applying the equation. Okay, what is the, I have given the procedure for solving by using slope deflection method. What is the first step? Step 1, finding the fixed end moment. Imagine the support A and B is fixed. Then what is the formula? You can refer the previous formula I have given in the last class. Refer the previous formula. If a beam is having a uniformly distributed load, I have given this list of formulas in the last class. What is the formula? WL square by 12, that is QL square by 12, which has to be used for finding MFAB. First you write solution, title is solution, and below that you write Step 1, fixed end moment, and below that MFAB. How will you find MFAB? What is Q here? 2 into 6 square divided by 12. That is the formula. And for span BC, you have to use PAB square by L square, and for MCB, PA square B by L square. If you have done the first step, then you can go for the step 2. Note here that due to fixedity at the support A, you will be not having the theta at A. So theta A will be 0 here, and you will be having theta B. And do you have any deflection here or settlement of support? There is no settlement of support. Hence, 3 delta by L will get cancelled, and only you will be having theta B alone. So what is the L for span 1? 6 2 EI by 6 into theta B. You will be getting equation 1. And when you are substituting MBC, that is between the span B and C, note here that you have a formula 2 EI by L. If you are substituting I, the I should be what? 2I here. So why it is written 2I? In the step of MBC, you have written 2I. Why? The problem has twice of moment of inertia.
This formula 2EI divided by L should be the formula. Why instead of I it has written 2I? Because span B to C you have a constant of 2I here. So you have to use 2I in the formula of MBC and MCB in our way. See, in the next step, span C to D, what is the I there? It is simply 1i, hence it is written as I here between CD and DC. Also at AB and BC, I is the only term written here. You have to find the R1 here. If in a problem they have given 2i, you have to substitute in the respective span.
If you have found out the equation here, there are 6 number of slope deflection equation. Next step is equilibrium equation. So how many equations you can write is 2 equilibrium equation. How you can say? By saying that how many number of theta you have here. Theta A is 0 and theta D is 0. Why it is 0? Both are fixed and it is 0. You have only theta B and theta C. So if you have 2 thetas, you have to write 2 equation. That is 2 equilibrium equation. What is equation 1 for theta B? BA and BC. So you at the joint B, you have 2 span. B to A and B to C. So you have to write the equilibrium equation first. What it is written? MBA plus MBC equals 0. That is the first equation. Now, for the second theta, what is the second theta? Theta C, what are the joints here? MCB plus MCD. So, these are the 2 span and the second equilibrium equation is written. So, you already know what is MBA and BC. By referring the previous equation, you have that. Just use simplify and substitute here. You will be getting 2 equation.
Those who are still not getting it, see, you have the joint B here. In B, you are having 2 span. What is the first span? B to A and B to C. What is written here? BA and BC. It will be 0. This first equation. Now, what is the second equation? At the joint C, what are the span you are having? C to B and C to D. Hence you are having CB and CD. These are the moments. Where you are going to get this moment? Refer the previous step. In previous step you will be having MCB, isn't it? Substitute that MCB and CD.
Theta B is 2.03 and theta C is 1.26. Then substitute this two answer in your slope deflection equation. So this is step 4, final moments. And here you have to write all the slope deflection equation with the theta. So you can refer step 2. Instead of theta B, you have to substitute this value, that is 2.03 or 1.26 respectively. If you substitute, you will be getting the net moment here. MAB as minus 6.68 kilonewton meter. You take this beam as an example. Analyze the continuous beam as shown in figure. Draw bending moment diagram. What is the difference between previous problem and this one? At the support C, so there was a fixed end, but you are having a hinged end, that is a roller. Yes, you have a roller end. What does it indicate in slope deflection method? You will be having theta C now. So can you recollect that? If you are having a fixed end, you will be not having theta. But if you are having a hinged or roller, you will be having theta C, and at the B you will be having a theta, and at A you will be not having a theta. So this is what our understanding by using the last problem. And we had two point loads there. Currently we have a point load and a UDL. So this is the difference. Rest of the things are same. You have a 4 steps in order to get the bending moment. What is the step 1? Step 1 is, write the solution, is finding the fixed end moment. A fixed beam carries a point load apart from center. What is the formula? PAB square by L square, and MBA is PA square B by L square. And for a fixed beam carrying UDL, QL square divided by 12 is minus and plus QL square by 12. This is our fixed end moment, step 1. Next is step 2, is finding the slope deflection equation. Now you know the formula, how to find MAB, MFAB plus 2EA by L, 2 theta A plus theta B minus 3 delta by L. This is the formula. You can find that. Do you have theta A? Do you have theta A here? No, theta A value will be 0, and this value will vanish, and you will be having theta B. Is there any given data regarding the settlement? There is no settlement which is given. Hence 3 delta by L will also be 0. You will be only having, you have already found out minus 26.67 plus 2EA by L is 6 meter, and rest of the things are 0. Hence you will be getting the equation 1. Similarly, you find equation 2, 3 and 4. Fixed end moment we have already found here. Theta A will be 0 at all the points. You will be having theta B only. And when you are substituting MBC, you will be having both theta B and theta C. Only settlement will be 0, and theta CB also you will be having EI theta B and EI theta C. you will be getting four number of equation. Yes, next is the third step, equilibrium equation. Now you know that at the point B you will be having sum of moment will be zero, that is MBA and MBC will be zero, and it is written here MBA and MBC will be equal to zero. Now you know those values, you have to add the equation and you will be getting next a major equation 1, and you know the moment will be zero at point C. There will be no moment at point C, hence MC will be zero. You know the moment at MC, that is MCB. You know the value of MCB, you have to substitute that, and you will be getting two equations, two major equations here, that is 1 and 2. You only have two unknowns. By using the calculator, you can find. So there is an option called equation, and degree of unknown is 2. You can press that. What are the unknowns here? Theta B and theta C. What is the value of theta B? 69, and theta C, 69, that is 70, and yes, EI theta B is 70 and EI theta C is minus 170. So what you can do is, instead of EI theta B and theta C, you can substitute the 70 and 170. You will be getting the moment. Substitute these two values, EI theta B and EI theta C, in slope deflection equation. You will be getting moment as MAB as minus 3.33 and MBA as 100 and 100. Finally, MCB as 0. Now by getting the answer, you can understand that you have done it correctly. Definitely you will be getting 20 out of 20 mark from this. If you are not getting MBA and MC are equal, that is you might get 94 and 100. If you are getting like that, then somewhere you have done error. According to the equilibrium equation, we have to get MCB as 0. So you can find here that if you substitute theta B and theta C, you will be getting the answer as 0 here. It satisfies the equilibrium equation condition, and you can draw the bending moment diagram. So this is your final bending moment diagram. It should be in terms of negative bending moment and positive bending moment. So you can see the two types of bending moment, and what is negative, which we currently arrived, that is at the point A you have to write 3.33 and at point B only the quantity. You got 100, the peak will be 100, and at point C it will be 0. You have to connect all the lines as negative bending moment. How to find the positive bending moment? I have given the formula in the previous problem. If a simply supported beam carries a point load apart from center, what is the formula? W AB by L. And if a simply supported beam carries a UDL, you have a formula of WL square by 8. Whenever you are having UDL, you should draw a parabolic curve. And whenever you have a point load, you should draw a straight line. Your positive bending moment will be 80 kN meter and 135 kN meter. Okay, with this, let me wind up this class. If you have anything to discuss, you have time.